Hi everyone, it's Sailor Mimzy. Today's video I'm going to be showing you how I used the first few sections of my Hobonichi planner. This is the second half of the year. This journal is officially done. Today is January 1st, 2017. Here's how thick it looks. I should grab my other one and compare it actually. Give me one sec. Yeah, I'd say the second half of the year turned out to be a lot chunkier than the first half. Do a compare. Okay, squish it. Look, it's the same. No. So I'll just let it go. More stuff in the second half versus the first. Alright. So if you're not familiar with how I use my Hobonichi planner slash journal, what I do is the first few sections, like there's like the monthly views and there's also I always skip a month and use the extra pages as overflow for writing or for things that don't fit on the page that I'm journaling on for the day and anything I just want to keep. So that's what goes on these pages that I'm about to show. And yes, this is a piece of string hanging out. It's not like a cobweb or anything. Alright, so let's get into it. Make sure I'm like in the frame. And I'm not really gonna explain what everything is, just do a quick flip through. I'm gonna have to hide some pages though because there's certain things on there that I don't want to show. So there's like those column month views. I use those to track birthdays, so I'm just gonna skip that and go straight into the month view two per page month view. Got these doodle ideas from an app that I have. It's just, you know when you decorate photos with stickers and stuff? That's where this is from. Pokemon. I did the first set of Pokemon in the first book that I had for the year. Some more Pokemon. Lettering. These are different Sadie bits that I wanted to remember. Are different, they're called sprays in the game Overwatch. So for winter they had these special sprays that came out for each character and they look like Kokeshi dolls. I thought that was super adorable, so I wanted to remember that. So I tried to doodle them. They're not in any order or anything, I just started, I think I started with Anna and then just went from there. Lottery ticket. Oh, my mom gave this to me. They always, like my parents always tuck in the lottery ticket and my birthday card. So there's that and just like different bits, like this is for mail, obviously like stamps and stuff. Postcard I found. The back is all filled out and it's sad because it wasn't mailed. And it was from 2 years ago. You guys might remember I did a art tip video on the tree. These notes and stuff. My husband went to, this is like extra writing that I had to add in because it didn't fit on the day of. It's from December 23rd. My husband went for a float at the float spa. And it was just writing about that. I didn't go, but He grabbed me a brochure and he grabbed me their business cards because he knew that I would want to keep one. And they're called jellyfish, which is pretty cool. Oops. So this is some of the wrapping paper that we used this year. Well, my husband used this year. I was just talking about stuff that I got for Christmas from my Secret Santa, which turned out to be my husband. And then my nephews got us each Xbox One headsets. I thought the instructions were kind of interesting looking. Kind of creepy looking with this like face. And then, oh, this is a tag I kept because my nephew wrote on it and his writing is very nice. And these are just some Christmas themed washies that I bought this year. I don't usually buy themed washies just because I don't want it to, not that it's gonna go to waste, but I can't use it year-round, you know, like, well, some of these I can, but a lot of them, like Merry Christmas, and I feel like the Christmas trees I can only use for, like, November, December. But we also use this to wrap presents and decorate cards and, like, little parcels and stuff. So that worked out. Oh, and that's it. So this was, yeah, so that's the beginning of August. Oh yeah, I have some extra pages at the end too. So at the end, after December 31st, there's just like plain graph paper. I don't think I finished all of it. I used some, I also taped in extra things. Like this is a menu from a place that's near my work. So just taped it in with washi, which folds up like that. And so just playing around with a pen that I got. Oh, the Lamy pen that I got. And my husband was playing with it too. And this was from the Hobonichi planner that I ordered a couple months ago. And then, oh, it's just off the testing pages I did here. Oh, and this was from Xbox Live. Well, like this crest is. So what they do is, at the end of the year, they sent this out. They didn't do this last year, but it just shows you your stats for the year, like your gaming things. So that was super cool, and they have like a personalized, like, crest. So I was gonna try drawing it, but I ran out of time, because this happened, I think, a couple days ago. So I just ended up printing it out and sticking it in here. And that's it. Papers, and then I didn't use this because I didn't really use this thing as a planner, it was a journal. But if I was using this as a planner, I would have used like the extra stuff at the back. Oh, and then I have my info filled in at the last page there. That didn't take too long, so I should just continue on actually with the rest of my flip through from, I think we left off when my husband used a towel instead of a blanket for bed. So here we are, it is November 15th. Day to use my head as a pillow. So I don't know if, oh my gosh, you hear the honking outside? I don't know what's going on. So it's day to use my head as a pillow. I don't mind, just because she rarely cuddles with me like to that extent. So I let her. Did a doodle of my favorite mug. Oh, and I added in this Gudetama tag before I got lost. So I just stuck it in there. I used put some string on and put tape over it. And then, oh, went to Lush and I bought this, my first massage bar, and it was called Peace, and it looked like that. Feels really good, and I don't mind the smell. I also bought this scarf poncho type thing. I don't even know how to explain, but it was really pretty. It looks like a lot of doodles on, more doodles than washi. Oh, this is actually a sticky note, but I just stuck it on there and then put in this washi bow because it looked cute. Oh, Sadie, you're snoring. We went to go see The Magnificent Seven in theaters. I bought my first winter jacket in years, and I ended up having to return it because of the size, and then when I switched the sizes, I ended up having to return that because the button, one of the buttons fell off, and it's not the kind that you sew. And then also there was a rip that I noticed, and I only worn it like two or three times, I think. And I didn't use it to do any like skiing or anything like extreme like that. So that was very disappointing. Oh, and a sticker, and I just doodled a Sadie underneath it. So this day, I was stressing out over school stuff, so I didn't do a whole bunch of journaling things. I really, like, when I have more time, I like to draw and like do lots in my journal. But when I'm super busy, or if I have like a really cool picture I want to share, then I put a huge picture on to take up some of the room. Because usually not a lot happens if I'm like doing schoolwork. So that was the case here. Oh, and what happened here, there was a creeper at work that was talking to me. Here, oh, I just stuck like a Tim Holtz card, and there's some writing underneath it. And this happened, I think, a day or two before it actually snowed here, where the snow actually stuck. But so there was no snow at all, and my husband and I were at a red light, and this car pulled up beside us. Remember, there's no snow at all. This car had snow all over it. So we were just staring at this guy in this car, and he like, I'm glad he didn't notice us, because we were just staring at him. So I tried drawing his car. I wanted to take a picture, but it was insane. His car was covered in snow. My husband and I look at each other, we're like, is he from the future? Warning us of the snow? But yeah, it was so strange seeing that. This was on, November 18th. Today's January 1st, and we've gone through two or three snowstorms, and we have another one coming. There's tons of snow out there. It's really crazy. We have no more room in our yard for the snow. This panda I doodled because I was playing Just Dance 2017, and I was doing Don't Stop Me Now by Queen, and then I ended up unlocking this panda mode or something. It was super cute, so I had to draw that. I went out for dinner with my husband that night, and we went to this place because I really like their kale salad. That's the only thing I ever order from there, kale salad and a soft pretzel, and the kale salad was gone, so I had a beet salad. It was good, but I really wanted the other one. Okay, so another example here. Lots of decorations and stuff because I spent a huge chunk of my day working on an assignment that was due that day. And what else did I do that night? I worked on the assignment as well as a present for my husband to give him on our anniversary. And this decoration, this is from a pack of Good Atomic sticker flakes. Obviously it was too cute to throw out because look at that pose, it's just too cute. And then I just drew like husband in his bear form, Sadie in her pig form in the background, and me there snoozing. And then I got these tapes from IKEA. They're really cool looking. I really like the design of them. So I use that as the background. And then, oh, on the 20th, it was our anniversary, wedding anniversary. So we were married for 6 years. So we were trying to stick to the traditional gift theme, and it was iron and candy. Such a random combination. Yeah, we were trying to stick to it. I ended up drawing him an Iron Man picture that I put in a little frame. And instead of getting him candy, I got him the appointment at the floating spa. It's something that he's always wanted to try because we were watching a vlog and people were doing it and it looked really cool. And I was amazed that they actually had places like that here. So I did that for him. We went to this restaurant in the city. We go there maybe once, maybe twice a year. But we don't go there often just because it's really expensive, but like the experience is really cool. Everyone that works there is super friendly and the food is always amazing. So that was only for very special occasions. What else did we do? Oh, yeah, I don't eat cow, pig, or chicken, but they had beef Wellington, and I've always wanted to try beef Wellington ever since my obsession with Gordon Ramsay began years ago. And one of their specials that they had at this restaurant was beef Wellington. So while the server was explaining that to us, he like said beef Wellington, and right away I looked at my husband, like my eyes just lit up, and I was like, yes, beef Wellington. And my husband saw me and he burst out laughing while the guy was listing the specials. And just for me, my husband ordered the beef Wellington so I could try it. It was actually really good. I don't think I can eat more than a slice though, because it just feels like a lot of meat. Anyway, so I decorated with washi and their stickers. Tried doing doodles of us. And my doodles of my husband never works out when I draw his human form. See, that's why I do the bear form. So he does not look like a weird pinhead shaped guy like that. Sorry, but he doesn't, Ellie. There's more writing. This is just Project Life card. And this is stickers from, I think, Dollar Tree. They had a really cool set of Victorian style flowers in their scrapbooking section. And this day, I don't think the camera is capturing it that well. I just want to play around with different papers. So this paper underneath everything is the same as this. It was just actually scrap leftover from when I made this super fast cover. And then I had leftover vellum paper from when I made my wedding invitations, and that was 6 years ago. So I was using my fountain pen on it. It wrote really nicely. So yeah, I just ripped off a piece of vellum around the shape of, you know, this space, and I just wrote on it, and then I stuck it on here. We went to go see that Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them movie. So there's just pictures from the movie magazine here and here. And it's a doodle of me in my winter jacket that looks really silly. So November 22nd, it finally snowed here. And on the news they said it was the latest that it's ever snowed in this city for the past 144 years. So I honestly was hoping it wasn't gonna snow till like later on, but it snowed, and it's been snowing like so much since. So at this point, I have one more chapter of reading and one more assignment to do for school. And I did a doodle of me. I'm not motivated or anything, can't focus. And this is a false misrepresentation of my desk. My desk is not clean like this at all. It's like piled with crap. And I went out with my sister that night. I obviously wasn't thinking. I should have worn my winter boots, but I ended up wearing my flats and socks and tights. It was a disgusting wetness. So bad. I just did it with my sister while we were out for dinner. And then, oh, I just drew a bear here. So I felt like drawing a bear, but my husband was asking if I would make a felted bear for him. I still have yet to do that. So my little celebratory doodle there. I finished my last assignment and handed it in. And I'm finally done with that cataloging class that I was on. It's just a fast doodle on some scrap paper of my Starbucks cup. It looks like such a mess, but it's supposed to have like the different leaves and vines and stuff. And is my first time trying a grande caramel brulee latte, a decaf grande caramel brulee latte. I didn't do a whole lot. Like, we just, husband and I went to the mall and like looked around and stuff. So on this day I have, this is just a cutout of a turkey, obviously. It's really pretty painting of a turkey. So it was Thanksgiving for the US. And this is from a calendar. Underneath is just me complaining about, let's see. I didn't do a whole lot. It was like part of my celebration to, part of my celebration for finishing that course. I wanted to eat mashed potatoes, but couldn't find any. And we didn't have any potatoes on hand. I didn't do a whole lot this day. But yeah, it was a good day. I think my husband and I were both on vacation, actually. I feel like I wasted a chunk of my vacation worrying about school stuff. And I cut out this frame from, it's not a Project Life card, but it was something similar to that. So I just trimmed the edges off and then stuck it in here. And then stamped my calendar stamp on there. And we went to the movies, and we went for crepes with my nephews. I drew a little thing here. They're both, one is 14, the other is 13, but they're both taller than me. Officially both taller than me, and it makes me so sad. They're growing too fast. Oh, and I only had a couple of hours of sleep the night before, so when we were at the theaters, and on our way to the theaters, like to watch this movie, I think it was a noon movie or something, an early show. I kept falling asleep. It was pretty embarrassing. And 26th is our last day of our November vacation, staycation. We watched that movie Bad Moms. I borrowed it from work. Husband went out to go help his friend's sister move. The guy on the radio said it was Catcher Day. Saturday. Oh, and this little, right up here in this doodle, my husband and I went out, I think the day, was it the day before or the day before that? I don't remember. At two different times in two different stores, two different women blatantly, like, I don't even know, they oogled him and both said hi to him. And I was just like, what's going on? And like, they did it right in front of me. And the way it happened was funny because the way these girls acted, it's like I was literally invisible. I know I'm a lot shorter than my husband, but I was still there. And like, they were like smiling right at him and they're like, hi, or like, hello. And I was like, does he know them? So it was pretty funny. Oh, and he did a doodle of a very bad but good dessert bar. It's called the Nanaimo bar. I hope I pronounced that right. Nanaimo bar. I did a little pig form of Sadie sniffing it. But yeah, they're really, really sweet. Like one little square is really good enough. Too much sweetness. So it's first day back at work. And it says here, sleepy, lazy, and I'm feeling cold with stupid hot flashes here and there. And it's feeling dizzy. All these complaints. And this green piece of paper was actually about to go into the recycling. The other side of it, I think, was from a flyer or something that was in our mailbox. And I like the color, so I just ripped off a piece and stuck one of my favorite stamps on it. But on this day, I started making the bed differently than I usually do. And Sadie likes it. She approves. She always goes and snoozes on my husband's side now. And this symbol is actually from Animal Crossing, from their latest update. That is interesting. It's like a Daruma mixed with a cat. And then, oh yeah, the decorations. This is, like, it's a big mash of, like, stickers and washi as usual. Oh, this was my clumsy day. Did you guys hear Sadie snort? Okay, so it's, like, super cold and snowy. So Sadie had to get her winter wardrobe out. She doesn't have wool underpants. I just doodled wool underpants. I think it'd be super cute if she did, though. Everything else, though, she has. And this is an ugly crochet hat toque thing that I made for her. And her winter jacket. Okay, yeah, so my clumsy day. Before I went into work, I went and got a small coffee from the place next door. And you know those sleeves that they put around coffees? So they had a basket of that on the counter. My coffee was ready. I went to go grab one. I don't know what the heck happened, but my hand, pretty much punched the basket that all the sleeves are in instead of, you know, picking up the sleeve like a normal person. So yeah, I punched the basket. It fell onto the other side of their counter. So I wasn't even able to clean it up and help them, like, because I made a stupid mess. And the worst part is it all fell into their sink that had stuff in it. Like, it fell into their dirty sink. And I felt like such an ass. So I kept apologizing and saying sorry. And the girl didn't really say anything. She was like fixing it up. And to make it worse, I still needed to ask her for a sleeve because I still wasn't able to get one. It was horrible. So embarrassing. I'm not usually clumsy like that too. It's like, ugh. Anyways. So that was one instance of clumsiness that day. The other one, I think I talk about it on the next page. And then, oh, I just wrote A Smile as Big as the Moon. It's a name of a book that I saw at work. Like, the title just caught me and I just thought it was really nice. So I copied that down. And, okay, yeah. Here's the second instance of my clumsiness from that other day. So at work, we have a cash box that we keep locked under the counter at the front. And when we're closing, that's the first thing that we have to put away in the safe. So I went to go do that as usual. I don't know what happened, but the box fell out of my hands, crashed to the floor, made a loud noise, and there was money everywhere. Like paper money and coins, everything. And I'm just like, oh my god, I can't believe this is happening again. And luckily I didn't get into trouble or anything. My coworkers came and like helped me pick stuff up. But it was just so embarrassing. And everyone thought I tripped, and I wish I could say that I did trip, because then that would have been like a better excuse, but I didn't trip. I was just walking, and it fell out of my hands. Ugh, so embarrassing. And there's a tiny little doodle here. It's Sadie rolled around and ended up, this is when we were sleeping, she rolled around and ended up with her butt by my face. What else is new? I love her. And then again, this is from that Dollar Tree pack with the Victorian flowers. And then the rest are, this is washi stickers. And then this is washi. And this is from a pack of like vintage looking ephemera. And the last day of November. Oh, here comes that scrap green paper that was gonna go into recycling again. So I was testing out a stamp that I had for my Christmas cards. That's a poor stamp job if you ask me. My fault, not the actual like rubber stamp. It was just bad inking and pressing down. Underneath there's just some writing. I'm talking about back pain. Oh my gosh, I just doodled this because I felt like drawing something. And I wanted to draw what I was talking about in my writing here, but I couldn't because I just couldn't draw it. I don't know why. It's just too much to draw maybe, but so I'll tell you guys the story. We went to Walmart, and when you first walk in, on the side, usually they have different displays, like, you know, bulk displays of things that they have on special or on sale. So usually it's like a pile of laundry detergents and like paper towels and things like that. And then right on the other side of that, that's where the cashier lines and all that stuff start. So one of the displays were really low in stock, so I could clearly see through, like, you know, the other side where the lineup was and the cashier and all that. And let's see, there was a woman in line on the other side where the cashier, like the first lineup was. I could clearly see her. She was hunched down, like she leaned down and she started coughing. But the whole time while she was doing it, she was staring right at me, like into my eyes, and that creeped me out. And at the same time, I wanted to laugh out loud. And like, the worst part was I couldn't look away. I was just mesmerized. I know this is such a ridiculous story, but it was funny. I couldn't believe it was happening. It was weird. It was a very weird thing. It's like she was staring into my eyes the whole time she was coughing, and her eyes were kind of like bulging out. Yeah, I just kept staring at her, and then we kept walking, like I didn't stop and stare. So by the time that she was out of my line of vision, like, you know, I didn't want to turn back, then finally I was able to like break my stare with her. It was so awkward. So I told my husband about it while we were walking through like the vegetables and stuff. That whole night, he would randomly reenact it. So it will be, like, even while we were still at Walmart or even after we left Walmart, I'll be talking to him, or he'll, like, you know, he'll turn to me for a second and go, hey, and I'll look at him and he'll start like coughing and his eyes will be bulging and staring at me. Oh my gosh, it's so funny. And there's a couple times where he did it while I was drinking something and I almost spit it out. But that brings us to the end of November already. Right, I just had to share that story. I just thought it was funny. It's just a really weird moment. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm still trying to catch up on my flip throughs because I wanted to start like the new year fresh, but obviously that's not gonna happen because the new year is already here. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, comments, or anything like that, just leave it in the comment section below. Talk to you guys later. Bye.